am a pharmacologist, and I've been working in the area of preclinical pharmacology for over 20 years. I never thought to be a scientist. I never grew up thinking, gosh, one day I want to discover the new penicillin. I must say that at university, somehow I ended up studying pharmaceutical chemistry, and I had a very inspiring professor of pharmacology. So she was extremely bright, extremely clever. That was probably the inspiration for me to start a career in pharmacology, or to thinking of starting a career in pharmacology. I had a chemistry set in my garage, but I don't think I did anything sophisticated. I think I was just mixing perfumes and sending it to my grandmother, really. She was the only client I could have at the time. I remember with excitement, it was 1993. I had been here for 2 years, and we established in our group intravital microscopy, which is a technique that allows you to visualize a blood vessel in a live animal. And I remember the excitement that when we set up this technique here, which was probably one of the first in the country, and to actually see a blood cell, which circulates in the blood, moving under our microscope. So that was very exciting. I think my job to me is like a hobby. So really, I think very often about our projects, our experiments, the excitement that derives by waiting for some data and interpret the data. But clearly there are other things that you do in life. You don't just work. I spend time with my children. I like a lot just music, so I listen to music. Occasionally I go to concerts, and I do some gardening. Nothing sophisticated, a bit of tanky job in the garden, but at least you are outdoor, and I enjoy that. I think what should be discovered is in the way tissues can repair. And so I think the most important discovery of the future will be how can we properly heal this injured tissue so that it will regain its normal functionality as it was before the attack took place. Perhaps that could also have overspill advantages in the area of aging, or how to reduce aging, or how to reduce the effect of aging, if you wish.